Let's see what Zai can do. Zai on the Pangolier. Mid lane. Looking to make a go on to Jabs. Jabs trying to punch back with the double damage. Yapzor are off the mark there with the roll. And an instant tip, of course, from Jabs sent the way off Yapzor as he makes that misplay. Ahmed actually turns. Oh, and mid one came back towards the lane. MP is the target. Secret coming in with the smoke gang. And MP escape. Secret. The Necrophos. The Invoker combo, very irritating for the Pango to play into, as each and every time Zai just loses the entirety of his mana. They do roll four, they do find Arbed there. Yapzor with a perfect opener. Big jabs. He's shot on the low ground at the moment. They do manage to get the steal here on the Shikuchi. Quick telekinesis. Can they burst down Nisha in time? They can't. Silence indeed coming out from Yapzor, stopping the immediate side. MP does still find it out to Nisha, but it's not enough damage. Nisha able to time-lapse back. The Magnetize ticks down jabs, and in comes Zai rolling forward, looking to find the connection onto DJ, but DJ jukes it with the Shikuchi. FNATIC, though, they've already lost two. That's also a bit of a bait here, as Arbed's there already as well. DJ Shikuchi's back in for telekinesis.
Gets the Storm stun too.
He's going to hold down mid one, and as well with the Spirit Vessel upon him, he's falling low, but he's able to turn, get the Lifestrike out, in fact, onto Arbed. Capsule's not done. He's looking for more puppies there for the wraparound. They get ice.
They want mid one, and they know it's the Bounty Runes. They throw the Tornado, even without the Vision.
Mid one, look for the Yules, but there's going to be jabs for the Winter's Curse. Holding mid one in place. Puppy's going to head over, because Secret Turn is done. Reaper Scythe's going to be down. Maybe Zai can do something big, though. Comes in with a three-man Rolling Thunder. Here's the two-man Boulder Smasher in Yapzor as he catches both Arbed and DJ. Secret get two more. As Nisha turns up, more kills for the Weaver. Jabs able to TP out on the high ground. The Secret aren't done, as now MP left alone. Yapzor kicks MP back into the hands of Secret. Winter's Curse is back online. Okay. The combo is there as well from the Invoker, but outside of the pit, Jabs, he's been found. Yapzor and Puppy keeping him away, so that capability with the big team fight ult will not be there for now. Roshan under half health. Jabs buying back, knowing the importance of being involved. They have to push Secret away from this Roshan. Sunstrike comes through, they know the status of Roshan's health. And FNATIC get in to do anything about this. The Winter's Curse comes down on the sideline. Nisha committing with the BKB, ready to fight, ready to head in. Zai charges forward with the Rolling Thunder out onto MP, bashing him about. The stun comes through from the Laguna Blade, but MP forced down to the bottom. He's still trying to retreat. Nisha's still trying to chase, cannot quite finish off MP. On the back lines, Rubik going up against Zai. Zai swashbuckles down to the low ground. Arbed, Deafening Blast comes through, but mid one pops the BKB. Lightstrike array to take down DJ. As Nisha continues to chase onto MP, Ghost Shroud's back up though. DJ, he's gonna head forward, but this could be a bit of a bait for Secret. Zai looking to try and get the Rolling Thunder off, but the Reaper side comes down. They'll be able to find Zai. Winter's Curse as well here is FNATIC. Can they set up for another kill? They've caught the two of them. The EMP combo coming through from Arbed as Puppy getting turned towards, stunned up as well by the Cold Snap. A second kill for FNATIC. Ice with the BKB turning towards Nisha. Nisha still has the Shikuchi and the time lapse.
Did you see them? They're looking to try to get a pick here.
Jump forward from Yapzor, does find the Boulder Smash stun. The force from MP will take ice to the safety on the side. Zai tries to go in with the Rolling Thunder. Does have the control, but there's the Winter's Curse. Jabs locks the two of them down. Laguna Blade comes down onto MP, but MP, he's able to heal himself back up, get up towards the high ground. Zai and Yapzor try to chase MP, but on the back lines, ice goes towards Puppy. Ice held down by the Frostbite. Lightstrike Array comes out as well from Mipon. They'll get the Spider. Nisha with the BKB looking to commit for more as he goes forward with the Shikuchi. Bugs out onto Arbed and MP. A buyback comes out from ice as Yapzor dies very deep in. The Scythe counterplay comes in as that's Yapzor gone for 2 minutes. He'll buy back. Ice off the back of his buyback will find Puppy. The BKB about to wear off. Nisha getting himself away from the EMP. As they're back into the game with four, FNATIC have five. Puppy down for 80 seconds. BKB's already been used pretty much from both sides. That is going to mean out of the two, Secret will feel that little bit more vulnerable as DJ is trying to lead in, but the sentry's already down. Instant silence from Yapzor. Self-fuels as well from DJ, trying to buy time to get out of this one. Can he escape the Cold Embrace? Time's been given to him by Jab. On the back, though, they're losing the Spider. Ice caught out. That's a dieback. Ice gone for nearly 2 minutes. And now Arbed. Once BKB's ready, so's Nisha's. Look at the telekinesis. EMP's down. Mid one, will he pop the BKB? He does. Ready to look to turn, but the Winter's Curse out from Jabs, making it hard to get towards Arbed. Arbed forced to the side. Mimble's BKB now ready. It's worn out. They go for the Yule Scepter, but with the Lotus Orb, he's going to throw himself up. And Arbed, he held his BKB that little bit longer, so he's still got his ready.
Laguna
Blade comes out. Jump forward with the Swashbuckle. Cataclysm's down. Arbed still alive. Finally falls. They've lost the Invoker, but they've lost Mid One as well on Secret. Both mids down. Mid One's got the buyback available. Arbed does have his ready. They'll wait for the high ground defense. And Yules. continue to back off. Ghost Round now available. Nisha for the BKB trying to go for this. The Cold Embrace is down the Ice Ice Ice. He's straight on top of Midborn. Midborn forced to the side. Glimmer Cape as well, keeping Midborn safe. Ice 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 as the BKB runs out. He has to back off. Midborn jumps in with the cheese. Back up to full. Burst down MP. Zai jumps in with the Rolling Thunder. Gets the stun onto Jabs. Jabs Glimmer Caped up. Shield Crash jump forward from Zai's. He's trying to find Ice 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 with Jabs. Nisha just diving straight into the bases. Jabs has the stun control onto Jabs. That's going to be Jabs dead. He's without buyback. 10 seconds until Arbed's back in the game.
They're keeping themselves on the high ground.
Nisha's going to head up. Does get the information as he sees them. Nisha popping the BKB straight away, looking for the commitment onto Arbed. Arbed gets the BKB off in time before another fire connects. Neon Disc keeping MP alive for now. Cold Embrace as well from Jabs will keep him safe as Fnatic. They've found Puppy. Zai rolling forward with the Thunder, but DJ blinks to the side. The Winter's Curse as well, holding back the Rolling Thunder. Nisha going straight for Arbed. Arbed does manage to get the Tornado out. DJ going in with the stolen Rolling Thunder, trying to find a connection, but the Laguna Blade comes down onto Arbed. Arbed buys back straight away to get into this fight. Ice 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 finds the second support on top.
And she's and the regression shard. Nisha.
Is there going to be enough damage? No, Zai's in. Does get the bash, the Abyssal Blade all? Holding down Ice Ice Ice, there's backup as well, the Laguna Blade, Ice 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 is gone, and MP, he got baited in by Ice Ice Ice, he came across trying to help, buybacks are coming out, they don't want to let MP go down, but Puppy, with the Frostbite Freezing Field, and MP gets some time with the Ondisk in there to help, the curse, the combo
the tornado.
From Arbed is enough, MP's still alive for now, but Nisha puts the BKB commit, that's going to be the Necroforce down as Nisha gets the connection onto Arbed with the slow from the Skadi, Arbed on the front lines, can he find some sort of opener? The secret still down a member. Yapsul goes forward for the room, but it's a bait. Straight away with a hex. Nisha, BKB pop. Nullifies one, looking for Arbed. The Cold Embrace and Lotus Orb. Keeping Arbed alive for now, but the Yules, the Rolling Thunder. Zai, he's got the control. Arbed's surrounded. The Bash is coming out. Arbed, he's falling low. He's down. Arbed's gone, but he's got the Aegis. He's ready for round two. They've lost Ice Ice Ice, but they've killed off the Pango. Zai does not have buyback. And again, they're still without Zai for a few seconds.
Oh, DJ, towards
the river. DJ, he's going to be fine for now. Well, maybe not with the sentry down. DJ.
Pop
the BKB, looks to try and turn with the opening onto Yapsul, but Yapsul gets forced down. Nisha's actually gone in on the high ground. He's popping his BKB for this commitment. Cold Embrace is there for now, keeping Arbed alive for the duration whilst that nullifier is affecting him. Yapsul rolls forward, they get the Laguna Blade onto Arbed, but Arbed keeps his distance with the BKB and the Ghost Ward gets out of there. Now the BKBs, they're gonna wear off for Secret. Secret have to be careful now. They've blown a lot for that initial opening. Ice Ice Ice, Cold Embrace again. Jabs keeping him alive, but Jabs focused down by the damage of the Wither. Jabs will fall as Yapsul gets the photograph. The Cataclysm coming down.
Catch
he hits
twice.
The wall.
Catch
they, get
twice.
They get themselves to see him, but they've lost Jabs. They've lost Ice 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 on Fnatic. Arbed, he's got to do something crazy to keep them in this one. A Spirit Vessel Cold snaps down onto Nisha. Nisha trying to hunt down Arbed. They've lost a third on Fnatic as Yapsul gets himself the double kill. 30 seconds until Ice 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 is back. One tier four to fall.
MP's gonna have to just try to walk in and start something. They don't have their other guys.
They're gonna keep them away. But already Yapsul, he's got the control on the side. The Bash coming through as well from Zai. Zai goes in with the Shield Crash. That's the Ancient now exposed.
They can't wait for the Broodmother.
They go for the game. They've got a fortification. 10 seconds until Ice 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 put on the side. MP getting caught. The Eon Disc able to take the off. He's able to look toward back towards the base. But Anisha focusing down the Ancient. 3 seconds till Ice 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 is there. Arbed and MP have to do something. Zai jumps forward with the Swashbuckler, the Refresher. Arbed, he's forced out the BKB from Midborn. The Ancient still getting pounded down. And in fact, Arbed just gets double. Laguna by Midborn, but Ice Ice Ice, he's chasing down Midborn, but Nisha looking towards the Ancient, finishes the game, GG is called. They're up against a Secret Huskar that they find a chance to slide into the draft.
See that traditionally,
on top lane, Midborn. May have got the Jingu Mastery stacks up, he's just level 1 though, so no Boundless Strike. Does have a Sal.
Oh, he's gonna turn.
Roll forward, Midborn, he can get some good lifesteal off with these hits, but one more's needed, and he can't quite find it, as DJ will be healed up by the Death Pulse. They get First Blood Fnatic. They do still lose DJ.
Spells the inner vitality.
DJ rolls
mid,
forward.
And there's the commit.
Got the opening. DJ with the kickback. Nisha underneath the tower with the cold snap. That'll get the job done. This is what we're talking about from DJ. There's one on the top lane. Ice 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 is getting gone on. DJ is there with a wraparound. He's going to roll forward. Looking towards Midborn. Midborn's starting to get the Jingu stats up on DJ, but DJ finds the stack for the line for the boulder smash. Midborn does get the stacks built up, and Midborn's pretty low. He'll turn with a boundless strike onto DJ, healing him back up. And with that Midborn can run DJ down, one more touch will do it. DJ hiding in the trees, but they'll spot him out as they get the kill on DJ. And he's pretty low. I mean, Zai could try for a little
Puppy's
bit of an
there.
Arrow. Puppy in deep with the read. The setups come through as the arrow flies in. Zai jumps forward with the burst, gets the kill. Jabs trying for the return kill onto Zai, will find it.
And now mid. Up mid.
And he gets DJ's there.
Two-man stun as well. Gets
once
Yapsul.
Again, I mean, Arbed could have gone down there. DJ in the right place at the right time. This mid lane, DJ is just not keeping his eyes off it at all. He's a liability. Fnatic, at the moment, they have ways of killing him. DJ comes across, Bowder Smash. There's the Strike Reaper Cypher as well. It'll do it. That's Nisha gone for 45. Puppy with the counterplay. Does find the call onto the two of them. DJ still alive for now. Puppy's trying to chase in the Battle Hunger upon him as well, but the Magnetize is ticking Puppy down. Another stone drop. Arrow from Zai connects, though. Onto DJ. DJ does fall, but Puppy will pay with his life. Mibon, can he get more cleanup kills? The Jingu Mastery build-up as Ice is Boundless Strike. He's heading back towards the tower. Jump forward from Zai. Another heal from Ice will not save him as the Splinter Blast flies through from Yapzol.
Rengar got a creep wave or two.
No, not again.
Everyone's
Nisha.
Here.
Hunt the Huskar is the strat for Fnatic, and it's working out so far. As he goes down, Mibon's going to try and find something in return. Puppy's there with the Battle Hunger on twice size. Mibon gets the Jingu up, but Abed with the Tornado, the Boulder Smash, stopping the Boundless Strike coming out. The Deafening Blast as well. Fnatic, double kill for Abed. A secret, they've got to run away, but Japs is there with the wraparound. Frostbite onto Yapzor. Yapzor's gone too.
Oh my god.
Top lane, Ice is the target.
They, with the call, they could be able to with an arrow lineup. Ice is stepping very far to try to secure the tower.
They're going to get him underneath the tower here by the creep wave arrow, and the dunk comes in. They'll get the kill. Ice is gone. They get the tower denied as well. Zai gets the last touch. Boundless as well, setting up onto DJ. DJ's able to turn, get the Boundless Smash out onto at least Puppy. The damage coming through, they get the Sunstrike out. Drew is doing a lot of damage with that Freezing Field. Will find Zai. But at the end of the day, Secret do get themselves the two kills. Moonlight Shadow's going to be available as well. There's the jump. Puffy instantly finds Ice. The Boulder Smash, the Tornado come through though. Trying to buy time for Ice to get the Ghost Shroud off, but he will. He turns Reaper Psyche down onto Nisha. Nisha's down for 75 seconds. It's Fnatic. They'll look to try and maybe lead him for more. Arbed still with full health and full mana. DJ rolls forward. Does get caught immediately by Puppy. Winter's Curse will lock down Arbed for now. But no one else by his side beating into him. Arbed's fine. And now with the rotation from the Weaver, the Sunstrike. Oh, Zai. Able to juke it.
So much map control, so they don't have to worry about some rush.
He's able to get the call on DJ. He's a crucial kill to find at the start of the fight because of how much of a nuisance he's been. They get the arrow, and they kill him in time. Splinter Blast brings him down to half health. He's still alive, though. Gets the chance for the two-man Boulder Smash to come out. Fnatic, they keep their distance. Mid-1 comes in from the side. They're Primal Spring and the Palance Strike. Burst down jabs. Gets DJ as well. He's been able to take down the two supports, and now Nisha ready to go in, but the Reaper sides down. Corner Graze comes out. Nisha's still alive. Finally falls to magic damage. It's too much. They get the kill, Fnatic and Arbed, still with the Tornado. Sunstrike down onto Puppy, Puppy will fall. Fnatic have lost two, but so is Secret. Secret only getting a CMK, they commit with the Winter's Curse. Do they really want to try and fight this though? Because the rest of Fnatic's heading across. The arrow comes in onto Ice. Nisha jumps forward, the Boundless Strike from Mid-1 will finish up the kill. But in return, MP is going to be able to find one. He'll turn now towards Nisha, get a second, double kill for MP. Zai and Yapzor heavily on the retreat. The Sunstrike being attempted, it will be off the mark. But DJ gets the silence.
He
the burst
more.
Damage comes through from Jab, setting up for MP's triple kill. Zai able to dodge the Tornado. DJ with a set at the same time towards mid though. Looks like maybe Arbed had too much attention down on that bottom lane as now he just gets jumped upon. Jabs with the Freezing Field, nearly killing off Zai. Not enough damage though as Yapzor's there with the Cold Embrace, healing up Zai. DJ jumps forward. They're still trying to fight this Fnatic despite the fact they've lost two heroes already. MP with the wraparound, looking towards Nisha. Nisha goes with the TP, the call, the stun. They managed to turn Nisha. It was a bait play, cancels the TP, turns, takes down MP once. MP's going to be back for round two with that Aegis. Reaper Sight down onto Puppy is not enough to kill off the Axe. Another call comes out from Puppy as he tries to retreat. The Radiance continuing to burn him down, but Puppy, he'll be able to get the blink off. MP, can he take down Nisha? He should be able to, and he can. Jump away attempted by Nisha, but the damage from MP.
Chill out. Oh, he's been spotted.
They know he's there. Oh.
Goodbye, Zai. He's dancing. He knows. He's got leap up in a sec, and he'll die in the tower. But yeah, MP gets the kill.
As Ice, confident to push this lane forward, does get jumped on. Here with the setup, Mibon coming in with the Wukong's command. Ice is just trying to walk his way out, but the EM disc just gets built. He's able to walk his way out to the side. Jabs, he'll dive for this. He gets the Freezing Field out, does a decent amount of damage to Zai, but it's allowed the rest of the Fnatic to get off. For now, Nisha tries to commit with the BKB. Self kills up from Ice, jump down onto the low ground by the Monkey King. The Cataclysm's out though. Nisha getting hit, getting brought low. He'll tick out. That's Nisha gone. Reaper side down onto Yapzor's Fnatic. Find three once again.
For that fight too.
Oh, using the Cataclysm there to get the whereabouts of the Monkey King. And Mibon's gone. He's got no buyback. GG is called. Fnatic.
We get five games.
We're about to get into, it is the fantastic Secret against the beautiful Fnatic. It's 2-for-2 at the moment.
But MP does make the mark. Oh, MP actually just gets tossed to the wave and now Mid-1.
Turn him with the avalanche onto Jabs. Jabs got the dive, the tree's coming in, and Jabs, he's gone.
And now they go for the secondary rune. Yapzor will be able to claim that one.
Oh, Secret. getting the runes, getting the kill. To mid one with a quick toss back. The Fisher will come down. DJ trying to block mid one off, a dive forward from Jabs. And they hold him in place long enough for MP to get the damage in there. That's the question. Jabs actually the one falling low. He's got to be careful. And indeed, mid one can keep the distance. Jabs nearly falls. And Fnatic, they just can't hold down a target long enough to allow MP to get the damage stacked up from the Fury Swipes. And with a TP in from Puppy,
there's a Mango on mid one too.
And Fnatic's got to run. Jabs, a couple of punches from Puppy's clubs, and that's Jabs down. MP comes back in, pops a Fairy Fire, but mid one's got the combo.
That's never a position where you want to be as an Ursa. Ursa wants to be dominating the early game, getting kill after kill. But bottom again.
Again, DJ and Arped making sort of these little steps to get themselves back in, but this time the Cold Embrace is going to be there from Yapzor. Arped in trouble as he gets focused down by the Winter's Curse. He gets bursted by the Splinter Blasters. They don't get the kill on Zai. DJ, he's gonna go down as well. Surely
the
he gets the echo out. Wait, hang on.
Whoa.
He did. Oh, God, DJ. All right.
Second time. Now MP, the Purge comes out, mid one.
Oh, the Fisher block as well, MP. Getting the swipes in, mid one's blocked off, but with the Supernova, the control for DJ, they'll get mid one. MP's able to take him down, get the gold. Secret's still trying to push it onto that tier one tower, but they got to back off. As again, DJ finding these Fisher block offs. Zai is caught incredibly deep as well. He was past the tier one tower. MP gets a double kill. DJ really set up something here. No, Secret's surely with the wraparound. They've got other heroes around. Nisha's got the backup and mid one and Puppy. They've got the vision as well. Sentry's down. He does have an Echo Slam available, but he can't get it out in time. Secret are able to find DJ. Ice. He's surrounded. They'll look for the rift out. Is he going to be in time?
Die.
It's the toss up. He's not getting home tonight. Jabs does come in with a wraparound, and Jabs does have a Supernova available if they see a chance. The ult's going to come out from Zai onto Jabs, but Ice. He's got the root there. He lays down the pit. Fnatic, they're still trying to close in onto this one. MP moves forward with the ultimate. Supernova down as well. Zai trying to run himself away. The Firestorm out as well. Zai's pretty tanky, though. The Supernova stun will not connect. They do jump forward.
Oh,
they're still trying to chase this, but they can't kill Zai. Now with the Fire Blast onto Jabs, Jabs is in trouble. He'll get some of the spirits out onto Zai. Zai continue to tick down low. In fact, Ice, he's got the damage potential. The Firestorm, the Fisher, they get him. Nisha is absolutely huge.
And he's getting completely uncontested free point. He's 201 last hits on. 17 minutes, that is well over the margin that you want to be at. Like 10 last hits a minute is amazing on a Dusa. He is passing that.
Look at the Yapzor, they'll find him. Oh. Winter's Curse comes out though. Yapzor tries for the TP out. And he's
going
to get out.
Abed's dead.
He's gone. They can't rift down in time. In fact, they lose MP as well. They'll lose two cores. Ice, and DJ will be able to escape.
Stone Gaze, Venno that we've talked about a million times, and then the Ice Daddy's going to be coming out soon.
Jump forward, looks towards Zai. The Fisher's out as well, but the Cone Embrace is there. Keeping Zai alive. Jump forward. DJ with the Echo Slam onto two. They're looking to try and bring down Zai. Zai's able to pop the hood. He's keeping himself alive.
It might be that.
Mid lane.
As they continue the siege. Radiant's
bottom tower. Curse. The curse, indeed. They're looking to start something on the side. They found themselves. Arbeck, quick combo from mid one. That's Arbeck gone. 45 seconds, he's down. Jabs will be able to dive back up to the high ground, but they were without their visage.
Attacking. And the Scotty is going to be finished up when he gets the time to pick it up. Zeiss is trying to stall this.
Ooh, and Amnesia is going to turn and take the kill with the help of mid one. Comes in with the combo. Ice is up in the air, straight back down, and he's gone.
That's tier 3.
Does have buyback available, but indeed, 22 minutes in, losing the tier 3 tower. Nisha, he's ready to continue moving forward. They get the Fisher. MP jumping. Can he kill Zai in time? He can't because the Cold Embrace comes through. Jabs diving forward, gets the Supernova out, but look at the attack damage.
Nisha doesn't
speed. Nisha just kills off the egg. MP's dead as well. Double kill for mid one. And the racks are just going. Fnatic's half of the map, making sure that they can't find anything else. And MP in the mid lane, trying to make a bit of an attempt onto mid one. But he's all alone. And MP.
Look at their net worth in comparison. They are below Yapzor on the Wyvern.
And they've got to do it twice. He's got that Aegis.
Do it twice.
Viper's popped. Nisha heads forward.
They're just... That's how confident they're feeling. They're just, yep, Nisha, park yourself all the way.
The DJ's blocked in the trees here by that warp by Zai. He's having to punch it down. He's already down to half health. The Winter's Curse coming out as well. The birds will be dropped to stop the too much damage going the way of the Shaker. But they've lost Ice. They've lost DJ. Absolutely steamrolled Fnatic.
But I mean, it's two racks, two sets of racks.
They can't
down.
Jump
they,
in.
They can't. They're still in Aegis.
Everybody's cancelled. There's
three
the jump.
Done.
The Fisher will come out onto mid point. They're trying their best. Jabs will go forward. Dives across, but it instantly gets taken down. DJ looking to move into position for an Echo Slam. He's trying for Puppy, but Yapsel's there with the Cold Embrace. Zai comes out with the ult. GG is called. Secret. Take game 5 here.